Nice to meet you, friends, again. So this is S. Pradeep, so from Smart Biotechnology. Today, actually, I'll be talking about compliments. So before this, I have seen many videos in the YouTube. Okay, it is relevant, but actually, I'll be explaining majorly three pathway. One is the classical pathway. Another one is the alternative pathway. Third one is the lectin pathway. So there is like, there is no link actually found in the net which explains all three correctly. So I'll just try to explain it briefly. So this can also be an important question in the exams, or which will be helpful in the competitive exams. So now I'll be explaining you about the, I'll just brief you what is a complement. So as I have written here, so complements, these are 26 to 30 serum proteins, means a protein which is found in the serum, which mainly provokes the innate immunity against the pathogen. Pathogen is nothing but we can also call it as antigens. So these antigens can be bacteria, protozoa, algae, fungi, or it can be a virus. These components, actually, now I'll be talking about component. These complement components can be activated in three pathway, as I'll be explaining you. Now, I'll be explaining you about what is a complement component, okay? So, in the complement component, I have C1, okay? I have C2, I have C3, I have C4, I have C5. So on to C9. So these are the complement components: C1, C2, C3, C4, C5 till C9. So these component plays a very important role, okay, in the provoking of innate immunity. This component actually is being activated by three pathway, which I'll be explaining. From this C5, from the component C5, actually this will be divided into C5A and C5B. So C5B along with C6, C7, C8, along with C9, they'll be forming membrane attacking complex. Okay, which I'll be explaining further. Let us start with classical pathway. Before which I'll be telling you about common terms, terminologies, which I'll be repeatedly using. The basic definitions. So first is nothing but C activation, means complement activation. So it's just we are altering the C proteins, which will interact with the next component. For example, if we alter C1, which I have told you before, it will interact with the C2. Next is nothing but C fixation. So only if there are in certain pathway which is dependent on antigen antibody complexes, such as classical pathway, that is called complement fixation. Next is nothing but we have hemolytic units, okay, which is like dilution of serum, which will lies 50% of standardized suspension of AB coated RBC. So it is related to with the drug, mostly when we, like for example, when we take a drug, so this drug, when it binds to RBC, it acts as a hapten. So these hapten will provoke the macrophages and it will hemolyte the RBC. Next is nothing but C inactivation or complement inactivation. So denaturation, nothing but temperature, when you supply a temperature, for example 96 to 98 degrees Celsius, that is usually a heat, early component resulting in loss of hemolytic activity. Next is very important is nothing but convertase / esterase. So it is actually altered C protein, that is we have C component. So more than one subunits of the C component will combine and they act as a proteolytic enzyme. Proteolytic enzyme means they break the other protein into a functional protein or functional. These proteins are nothing but a complement. Now I'll be explaining you in depth about the activation of the complement system. First, let me talk about classical pathway. So actually it is basically it occurs whenever there is an antigen enter into a body. So anything foreign substance entering into a body, it is recognized as an antigen by the body, which we all know. Now I have drawn a cell. Okay, so this cell is infected by an antigen. Now the cell is infected by an antigen. So antibody, which is produced by what you call the B cells, that is plasma cells, it has bound to the infected cell. To these infected cell, the complement, we can call the initial complement or the complement component C1q, which is inactive, will bind to the FC portion. So this is nothing but your FC. This is nothing but FC binding region of the antibody. So when it binds to the FC binding region of the antibody, the C1q gets activated. The C1q further has complement 1R and complement 1S as a subsystem, which gets further activated. Now from here, the further what you call complement components get activated. So when you see now this C1S is active. Okay, now this C1, now I am considering C1Q, R and S as C1. C1 was inactive and C1 became active. Now this C1, what it will do is, now the complement 2 will come. This complement 2, with the help of complement 1, gets proteolytic, or we called it gets broken down into C2A and C2B. Further, the C1, that is actually this is C1Q only, which consists of C1QRS. Now C4. C4 comes, actually this is C2 and this is C4. C4 comes and it gets converted into C4A and C4B. Now what happens is, these C2A and C4B, C2A and C4B, it chemically, it will bind to this surface. It will chemically bind to this surface. There is nothing but antigen antibody surface. These molecules will bind here. It will covalently bind. Okay. Now these forms C3 convertase. I have told you before what is a convertase. So convertase is an altered protein. Altered means combination of two proteins. Altered proteins which act as a proteolytic enzyme. So now this C3 convertase, will cleave C3 into C3A and C3B. Now this C3A is very important, biologically, which I'll be telling you again. Now this C3B will covalently bound to C2A and C4B. Now C2A, C4B and C3B will form another convertase. It is called C5 convertase. So after C3, so every pathway will form C3 convertase and C5 convertase. So this is the common thing. Now this C5 convertase, as I told, this will convert, or this will act as a proteolytic enzyme, and it will cleave C5 to C5A and C5B. Now I'll be talking about that C3A and C5A. As I told, no, C3A will have biological function. Now again, C5A will also have a biological function. Now what does this C3A will do? The C3A and C5A are chemoattractive agents. We can call chemoattractive agents or chemoattractive proteins. What the C3A, the complement, will do is, this will stimulate inflammation by attracting mast cells and basophils. So these are nothing but granulocyte cells. So these are nothing but granulocytes. They release heparin. So mainly in case of allergic reaction, that is a hypersensitive reaction. So okay, this is this plays a very important role. Now I'll be talking about C5A. So what does this C5A do is, this will this is also a chemoattractant, so it will attract macrophages. It will just attract the macrophages and make it ready for its function. Now, so these are the mainly the two biological functions. Now, what will happen to C5B? Actually, our C5B, we also have C6, we also have C7, we also have C8. Along with multiple C9. C5B, C6, C7, C8, along with multiple C9 complements, they form MAC. These are called membrane associated or attacking complexes. Okay, so this is very important, which helps in the cell lysis. So I have told you very important two things. One is nothing but this thing, what we called stimulation of inflammation, is the first very important thing. Next, this is the last thing. Cell lysis will occur at last. Now I'll be talking about C3B. I haven't told about C3B. So C3B helps in opsonization. What is opsonization is, this C3B will bind to the surface, antigen antibody surface, which I have drawn earlier, and it will make the damaged cell compatible. Compatible in the sense, physically or chemically, to entrap by the what you call macrophages, which are produced by C5A. Opsonization nothing but C3B plus antigen will be entrapped by macrophages and phagocytosis occurs. Okay, so this is almost the end of the classical pathway, but after this, actually there comes the MAC. So what happens is, immediately the C5B, what we have got, C5B will be covalently binding to the C5B, C6, C7, C8 will come and bind. See, many C9 will come. So there is a hole formed on the cell. Hole, or we can say there is a pore, large pore formed on the cell, which will allow the ions and other molecules to enter into the cell, which will ultimately cause lysis of a cell. So this is nothing but classical pathway, which is dependent on antigen antibody. That was the end of the classical pathway. Now I'll be talking about alternative pathway. Okay, why the name alternative? Classical means normal, which we know. Alternative is nothing but additional proteins play a important role in the activation of the complement. As I have written over there, these are active at very low level. It is very not majorly activated. Okay, when the antigen surface is a lipopolysaccharide, this pathway is activated. Now, actually, this is very important. Okay, this pathway is not dependent on antibody. So this is a major difference between alternative pathway and classical pathway, that they are not dependent. Alternative is not dependent on the antibody. Now, the C3 complement, which is formed by the classical pathway, at very low level, it can enter the alternative pathway. So this starts with C3. Sometimes the C3 complement is hydrolyzed. So this is C3 molecule. If you assume C3 molecule is hydrolyzed, that is addition of the water. Now what happens is, so this is the initiation. Okay, there is no antibody involved. This is very important. Now this C3, I'll draw it. Okay, this is nothing but C3 and this is hydrolyzed. It is bound by factor B. So factor B, okay, different factors. So this is the second one, okay. Now I'll be drawing the third one. What will happen is, this is your C3 and this is your H2O and this is nothing but small b, capital B. So this is BA and this is factor D. So what has happened over here is, factor D will come and bind here. Okay, factor B and factor D. D will come and bind the B, and this factor B is converted into BA and BB. Okay, BA is being left, but BB will link to the hydrolyzed C3 complement itself. Okay, now what will happen again is, this C3H2O along with BB, again we know factor D is responsible. Again one more protein called P. What is this P? Sorry, I have told C3H2O, it is nothing but hydrolyzed BB the factor, and FD is a D factor, and this is P, it's not propadine. So these are not, this, that's why it is called alternative pathway. Now what happens is, I'll show you. Now this all, that is C3 hydrolyzed factor B and factor D and propadine, along with that they form C3 initiation convertase. Now what will happen, you will see. Now this C3 initiation convertase is responsible, as I told, convertase means it is a complement. Okay, no, it is a complement which will act as a proteolytic enzyme. So it is a altered protein which act as a proteolytic enzyme for the another complement. So this is C3. So this C3 initiation convertase will convert C3 to C3A, C3B. After this, almost it is same. After C3 convertase formation, of course there will be C5 convertase, and the remaining process is same, but the initiation will differ, that you should remember. So this is nothing but C3A and this is nothing but C3B. Now this C3B, again it will bind to factor B. Okay, again factor D will come, it will cleave factor B like this. I'll write, okay, this is C3B and it will cleave factor B to small b, that is factor BB, and this is BA, and now along with that again propadine will come. Now these will form C5 convertase. So this is a major difference, that's it. Now this C5 convertase, we know what this can do. This will convert C5 to C5A and C5B. Okay, now I have told C3A, C5A has a biological function which is similar to the classical pathway. As I told, C3A will stimulate the inflammation and C5A will stimulate, both are chemoattractant. They'll attract, C3A will attract mast cell and basophil, C5A will attract the macrophages. Okay, now Here one more thing is very important. The C3B which is produced, this produced is covalently linked, as I have told in the, I have shown in the last this thing, this diagram is very important. So this C3B will, what happens is this C3B, this is not antibody, okay, there will be no antibody over there. This C3B will, B will covalently link to the what you call the infected cell. To this C3B, again, what happens is this C3B is there. No, again, there will be many C3Bs produced which can covalently link it to any part of this cell. Many thousands of them will link to the cell. Otherwise, the C3B can form a dimer with C3B along with cap, that is BB factor. So it is called as a trimer. Okay, how it will form, I'll show. It will be covalently linked, it will form C3B. Okay, again it will form C3B. Again there will be factor B. So it can form a, what you call, so this can form a trimer. This can form a trimer. Okay, so this is very important over there. C3B accumulates. Okay, that is only a very important factor, what I thought. Now here, rest all is same. C3B is a chemoattractant, and this is a chemoattract. This will attract the cells, what I have told. This will attract the cells, what I have told. Next is C5B. Similar, this will attract to C6, C7, C8, which will covalently bind or bound to the antigen. Okay, which is lipopolysaccharide. This is very important. Okay, especially lipopolysaccharide. Many C9s, many additional C9s will come and bind to these. There is a hole or pore formation in a large size on the surface of the antigen. Many ions and soluble molecules is inserted, which will lead to the lysis of the cell. So remember, inflammation is occurring, here lysis is occurring. C3B which is accumulating, which will also enhance the, what you call, phagocytosis process by opsonization. Okay, so this is the end of the alternative pathway. This is the alternative pathway. Okay, so you can see it. Okay, you can see it clearly. What and all I have told is there in this cycle. So you can just refer the cycle. See, C3 converted to C3B, C3A. So it will be more easy. Okay, so this is the cycle for the alternative pathway. Okay, now I'll be going to lectin pathway. Okay, this is very important. This is an another pathway. Okay, lectin pathway. So all this pathway will activate the complement. That's it. So you can see that what is a lectin pathway. Lectin pathway, these are the soluble proteins. Okay, lectin are soluble protein. They recognize specific carbohydrates, CHO means carbohydrate components present on microbial surface. So this lectin is usually present in the host cell itself. Let us take ourselves. Okay, so lectin is present in ourselves. Okay, but the carbohydrate, so these carbohydrate components present on microbial surface, I mean this is antigen. This is present on the antigen surface. Next, actually I am taking mannose. Mannose is nothing but it is a carbohydrate. MBL means mannose binding lectin was first discovered lectin. MBL is nothing but they bind to the, MBL is nothing but the mannose binding lectin. These lectin, they bind to the mannose containing carbohydrate. Mannose is a carbohydrate. So what does it mean is, the lectin which is present in the body, whenever the antigen comes inside a body, this lectin which is present in the body will bind to the carbohydrate, that is mannose surface of the antigen, which can be a bacteria, fungi, protozoa and or a virus. Now this is nothing but an antigen. Okay, but here you should remember there is no antibody involved. Again, it is antibody independent. Remember, alternative and your lectin pathway is independent of antibody. There is no role for the antibody. This is very important. Now this is your antigen surface which is having carbohydrate. This is your carbohydrate, mannose. Now this MBL complex, what is MBL? MBL is nothing but mannose binding lectin complex will bind to the mannose. So this is nothing but epitope. We can say it is at a as an epitope. So these MBL actually have two component or two parts, MASP1, MASP2, which is nothing but M means MBL, mannose. Here I have written C, mannose binding lectin associated serine proteins 1 and mannose binding lectin, it is MBL associated serine protein 2. This is very important. Now, as usual, what happens will happen. Okay, now remember MASP2, this is MASP2. Now what happens? MASP2, it acts as a convertase. I have told what is a convertase. So convertase are the altered proteins. So these are the altered proteins of MASP, which will act as a proteolytic enzyme and it will cleave C2. Here you see, it will cleave C2 as well as C4. It will cleave C2 as C2A and C2B. It will cleave C4 as C4A and C4B. Now, as usual, from this it is same. C2A and C4B will combine. See, covalently to the microbial surface, which is an antigen, and they form C3 convertase. After the C3 convertase, everything is same. It is common as the all the pathway. Now, this C3 convertase will convert C3A and C3B. Okay, C3A has a biological function. I have told they stimulate the phagocytosis. Just remember C3A, C3B, phagocytosis. C3B here, what it will do? C2A, C4B and C3B, they combine to form C5 convertase, which will convert C5 to C5. To C5A and C5B. C5A again has a biological function as a chemoattractant, will attract the macrophages, same. C5B along with C6, C7, C8 and C9, they form a membrane attacking complex on the antigen and cause cell lysis. So inflammation is also occurring. C3A, lysis also occurring, and this is nothing but phagocytosis again. C5A will attract the macrophages for the phagocytosis due to C3B, which will cause the opsonization. This is very important. Now, lectin pathway is a combination of both classical pathway as well as alternative pathway. This is very, very, that's why it is very important. Because after the C3 convertase, everything is same as classical pathway. Okay. It is similar to alternative pathway. Why? Because there is no antibody involved. So this is the end of the lectin pathway. As a MAC is formed, after the MAC is formed, there is a large pore produced. Ions, other soluble molecules will enter into it along with other small molecules. It causes a cell lysis. Three steps you should remember. Inflammation, opsonization and cell lysis. These are the major thing. Now, so this is the end of the three pathway. Now, what are the differences? Differences between three pathway. So, first is nothing but classical. Alternative and lectin. So, most common, I can tell most common. It is nothing but, as I told, occurs at low level. This is also occurs at low level. We can assume, okay. Not assume, actually it occurs at low level. Now, this is antigen antibody complex. It is dependent. Here only antigen. AG is antigen, AB is antibody. Here also only antigen. This antigen is alternative is lipopolysaccharide. Okay. And these antigen is nothing but mannose. Nothing but carbohydrate, where the lectin will bind, forming mannose binding lectin. Okay, next, very important. Another examples also you can write as no factors involved. Factor B and factor D is involved. Combination of both, just remember, combination of both classical pathway and alternative pathway. So what are the major things? Major things occurring is nothing but C3 convertase, C5 convertase, next is nothing but inflammation mediation, next we have after the inflammation mediation, I have opsonization. After the opsonization is a process where the complement will compatible. We can say in the computer language, we can say compatible. Compatible means we know it compatibles the antigen to the macrophages. After that, we have cell lysis. These are the common things. Next, I have C5 convertase, again common. C3A and C5A function is same. C3B function we know, phagocytosis. Next, C5B will bind with C6, C7, C8, C9, forming membrane attacking complex, which will help in the cell lysis. So these are the common things and these are the major differences between these three pathways. Thank you. If you like this topic, please subscribe it, okay, for the latest topic. Which I am going to describe. So this is very easy. Just you write it down whatever I have told, and you just before the exams or any competitive exam, you can watch this video. Okay. Thank you.